In this video, I'm going to take these examples right here and find the unknown either on the right-hand side or on the left-hand side that they're asking about. The way that they have written these questions, they look like they're in scientific notation, but they're not, because the mantissa, your leading number in all your cases, is not between 1 and 10, except here in the third one. Now, just a side note, it's not something that most people know, but when it's not a mantissa between 1 and 10, if it's, for instance, something like this, okay, or this, or even this, when it's outside of that range, then we call it a significand. In any case, we're not interested in the name, we're interested in trying to solve for the unknown. The word equivalence here, you will notice that I highlighted these equals. That's what equivalence means, that you have your left hand side equal to the right hand side. Let's try the first one to solve for that unknown by a process which I call bigger and smaller. First example. In this first example, I know everything on the left-hand side. I know the leading number and I know the exponent. On the right-hand side, I only know the leading number. Now, since I know the leading number in both, I am going actually from the left-hand side to the right-hand side because I know everything on the left-hand side and my question mark is on the right-hand side. So I always move in the direction towards the question mark. My leading number was 14.815. And now it transitioned into 1481.5. So as you can see, it got bigger in magnitude. It got bigger in magnitude by multiplying it by 10 two times. So I like to write, we got bigger by 2, or much simpler, the decimal has shifted two places, which is really just multiplication or division, in this case, multiplication by 10. So what you have to do when this happens, if you notice that it gets bigger by 2, to counterbalance so that they're still equal, your exponent in this case must get smaller by the same amount, smaller by 2, which is now smaller by 2, meaning division by 10 two times. But you may know, well, division by 2 10 times, okay, division has a negative 2. So your question mark becomes 120, and it got smaller by 2. So the answer is 118. Again, this got bigger by 2 in magnitude, and therefore the other one must get smaller by 2. Let's try it on the second example to hopefully make it a little bit easier to understand. That's my second example. I'll paste it here. Erase these. Now I notice I have everything on the right-hand side and my question mark is on the left-hand side. So the direction I'll be moving is to the left. In the previous example, as you saw here, I knew both of these leading numbers. While in this example, I know the exponents. So I can gauge, since I'm going from the right to the left, so I'm going in this direction, what has happened to the exponent? Did it get bigger or did it get smaller? And be careful because you have negative exponents. So in order for me to go from negative 201 and get to negative 199, I actually had to make it bigger by 2. So this got bigger by 2. And as a result, as in the previous case, this will have to get smaller. So this concept of bigger, smaller, so smaller by 2. Now, smaller by 2 for a number means that we're going to take our decimal right here and make the number smaller by 2 decimal places. So it's going to shift 2 decimal places and give us our answer. That's our question. So bigger, smaller, and all you're doing is either adding or subtracting to the exponent or moving the decimal to the leading number. That's the second example. Let's try it for a third example. And I will erase these. Try it. Now my question mark is on the right hand side. I know everything on the left hand side. So I will be going in this direction. Always from what you know to what you don't know. So now negative 88. If I want to get to negative 91, this will have to get smaller. So notice we would have to do this, and it's actually by 3 because it's 91, and that means that our decimal will have to make the number bigger by 3. So if one gets smaller, the other one must get bigger. And moving the decimal to make it bigger, so to make the magnitude bigger, you have to shift the decimal 3 times, where your answer or your question mark would be this. I hope these examples you can use to try to solve some of these equivalence questions.